This past Friday, AEW would reveal that a free agent is set to debut this coming Wednesday on Dynamite. The mystery debutant has been handed the opportunity to enter the Face of the Revolution ladder match, with them set to take on Isiah Kassidy of Private Party and the Hardy Family Office in a qualifying match. The winner of the eventual ladder match will earn an opportunity at the AEW TNT title. AEW President Tony Khan would take to Twitter to discuss the signing, potentially leaving hints that we will break down in today's video. And Khan would say, "The Forbidden Door can be open for anyone from any promotion in the world, whether or not it's a company AEW is on good terms with, even if it's someone from a company that's open for business. They're also welcome to slam the door in the face of their prior company." The big announcement for Wednesday's Dynamite that we refer to on AEW Rampage, a free agent debut, and the person walking through the Forbidden Door are one and the same. They're walking through the door, signing a contract, and then slamming the door shut Wednesday on AEW Dynamite. So, what could the tweets mean and who could he be referring to? Well, let's take a look at 10 wrestlers that could debut this Wednesday on AEW Dynamite. And before we get into it, make sure you subscribe with notifications turned on so you don't miss the latest wrestling news. And check out the relaunched WrestlePlanet.net for daily wrestling articles. Mustafa Ali has garnered a lot of attention in recent days after telling the world via Twitter that he had requested his release from WWE. He would say that he has a message bigger than his pro wrestling dreams and he couldn't deliver this message if he stayed. Mustafa hasn't wrestled on WWE television since Crown Jewel 2021 back in October and hasn't been touring with the company since November. One would assume that WWE would grant his release considering the multitude of wrestlers in the company has already let go due to budget cuts as of late. However, recent reports suggests that this is not the case, as WWE refuses to let him go, citing that he has value, despite never using him. Hashtag Free Ali has gained a lot of traction amongst fans, and WWE may be forced to give in to his demands, and if that does happen, Mustafa could jump to AEW. Tony Khan's tweet about the signing made it sound like the mystery wrestler was somebody from WWE who has a gripe, and perhaps Mustafa has managed to get out of his contract using other means. I'll be honest, it's a long shot, but he definitely checked all of the other boxes. Another wrestler fed up with WWE is Jeff Hardy, the brother of AEW star Matt Hardy. Jeff was released by WWE following an incident at an untelevised live event in Texas, where mid-match, Hardy would walk out through the crowd. Following the show, it was reported that WWE had ordered him to go into rehab, with this insinuating that he had relapsed, although he rejected the offer, leading to his release. Through the help of a lawyer, Hardy was able to get the results of his WWE drug test, which came back negative, showing that he is in fact ready to go. WWE then appeared to regret their decision as they called him to ask him to come back, an offer that included a spot in the Hall of Fame, but Jeff said no. Although Jeff Hardy's 90-day non-compete clause is still not over, he may have been able to use his lawyer to escape his contract entirely, perhaps due to unfair dismissal and libel. Jeff's brother Matt has teased a Hardy Boys reunion, and maybe this storyline could begin when his brother takes on his protege Isiah Kassidy. This makes even more sense when you remember Andrade El Idolo looks set to take over leadership of the Hardy Family Office stable, and let's not forget the final clue, it's the Face of the Revolution ladder match. Next, let's go to a bit of a wild card as we go to indie sensation Matt Cardona. The former Zack Ryder has already had a brief run in AEW when he fought alongside the Nightmare Family to defeat the Dark Order back in mid-2020. Having since turned himself into one of the best heels in wrestling, he would be a great addition to the AEW roster. Most recently, Cardona has won the Impact Digital Media Championship after making his return to the company. However, he has confirmed that he is not under contract and he is still technically a free agent. This means he could put pen to paper and sign with AEW this Wednesday. Tony Khan did make it seem that the mystery wrestler is disgruntled with his former employer, whereas in Matt's case, he is under good terms with Impact, GCW, and NWA, although he could perhaps be referring to his 2020 WWE release. That said, if it's anyone from Impact Wrestling, it's most likely the journeyman Deathmatch King. Johnny Gargano made headlines in 2021 after he announced he would not be renewing his WWE contract, which ultimately expired in early December. With NXT changing its outlook and presentation, becoming something very different from what Gargano had known to be his home for the past 6 years, he decided to leave. Many fans did expect him to show up on the January 26th edition of Dynamite, which was held in his hometown of Cleveland, Ohio, with chants of Johnny Wrestling being heard throughout the show. Johnny would later thank his fans, but explained that he wanted wanted to spend more time with his pregnant wife Candice LeRae and his baby. With Candice still yet to give birth, it's possible that Gargano may not debut in AEW anytime soon, although perhaps he's ready to swerve fans. AEW's schedule has been praised by its talents as being non-restrictive, meaning he could join the roster without hindering his ability to be there for his family. A former member of the Lucha House Party, Lince Dorado spent the majority of his 5-year WWE career as either a singles cruiserweight competitor or as part of a tag team with his stablemates Kalisto and Gran Metalik. Feeling that he had hit a glass ceiling in WWE, Dorado asked for his release and was eventually granted his wish, being included in the November 2021 cuts. With his non-compete clause having now expired, Dorado could be the mystery wrestler debuting on Dynamite. Recently, Dorado has teased a move to AEW after Evil Uno posted an Instagram picture showing his win-loss record, with the Luchador replying to the post, telling Uno that he'll see him soon. With regards to Tony's hints about the mystery wrestler, Dorado does seem to make sense. He is a free agent that would be slamming the door shut on a company which saw him as nothing more than a curtain jerker lost in the shuffle. Bray Wyatt is one of, if not the most creative individuals to be showcased on WWE television in recent years, with his evolution from cult leader to kids entertainer, and finally to the terrifying fiend gripping the fans' attention. However, despite his best efforts, WWE dropped the ball with his booking, with his final run falling flat at WrestleMania 37. Following his release from WWE in July 2021, many have anticipated Wyatt's next move, and his name remains on the lips of fans whenever there is a surprise teased, and this week is no different. It's now been 3 months since his non-compete clause expired, as fans are still hopeful to see him debut in AEW. Tony Khan's tweet does seem logical when applied to Bray, as he is a free agent from a company AEW isn't on good terms with a desire to show what he can really do. Whilst the now Wyndham has been busy with his role in an upcoming horror movie, it's likely that filming has been wrapped up, with production beginning in late November. Perhaps it could be time for AEW to let him in. Karrion Kross tops a long list of wrestlers that had a great run in NXT before being buried on the main roster. After a disastrous stint on Monday Night Raw, his release seemed like a chance for a new beginning and likely came as somewhat of a relief. Since then, he has repackaged himself as Killer Kross once again and is looking forward to working for another company. Kross has recently made comments about AEW in an interview with CBS Sports, teasing a debut and talking about how he believes he could bring something new to the table. Fans aware of his successful NXT run know his true potential, and it would be a smart addition to the All Elite Wrestling roster. Much like Bray, Tony's tweet makes sense for Kross, as he was booked horribly by WWE and is a free agent with a point to prove. He will likely not return to WWE anytime soon, so it's possible that he may be the man slamming the door shut. Samoa Joe has had a crazy time in WWE over the last few months. Following a shocking release in April 2021, Joe made a return to WWE to work for Triple H in NXT, with the head of the Black and Gold brand furious that he was let go. Joe went on to win the NXT title, although the eventual NXT 2.0 rebrand saw Joe mysteriously vacate the belt due to an undisclosed injury. In January 2020, less than a year after his release, Joe was released again by WWE, with his last ever WWE match being his NXT Championship win over Karrion Kross at TakeOver 36. Having been released on January 6th, he was only subject to a 30-day non-compete clause, which at this point has now expired. A man twice released by WWE, it is quite apparent that Samoa Joe may never return to WWE in a wrestling capacity, with them seeing him as no more than a performance center coach at this stage of his career. Joe remains as one of the best big men in the sport today, and AEW is the perfect platform for one last run for the Samoan submission machine. According to recent reports from Fightful Select, Juice Robinson's contract with New Japan Pro Wrestling has expired as of January 31st, 2022. Robinson had been with the promotion since 2015, where he became the first ever American to hold the IWGP United States Championship, as well as the first ever wrestler to win it twice. In the past, Robinson has had several matches with some of AEW's top contenders, including Cody Rhodes, Jon Moxley, and Lance Archer. However, he is yet to do so under the AEW banner. Robinson hasn't competed in Japan since March 2021, instead only working on New Japan's United States-based shows. It's likely that he won't return to NJPW, instead choosing to sign for an established United States-based promotion. Despite Tony Khan's tweet insinuating that the mystery wrestler is from a promotion that AEW are on bad terms with, the Forbidden Door aspect does point to New Japan Pro Wrestling, and Juice is a recent New Japan talent that is now a free agent. Perhaps the aggressive nature of the tweet could hint at the start of a kayfabe feud between New Japan and All Elite Wrestling. The most likely candidate on this list to fill the mystery spot, at least to me, is Keith Lee. Keith was another one of NXT's major successes before a disappointing main roster run that saw his career fall flat. Repackaged as Bearcat Lee, fans were vocal about their disappointment with how Lee was being treated, and soon after, he was shockingly released in November 2021. As of right now, he is a free agent with his non-compete clause expiring on February 2nd, and he again is a talent with a point to prove. A recent report from the Wrestling Observer noted that AEW have had internal talks over bringing Keith Lee in and suggested a deal may have already been signed. Keith would be a welcome addition to AEW, and it is possible that he could go on to win both the Face of the Revolution ladder match as well as the TNT title. He could begin his All Elite Wrestling career in dominating fashion before eventually moving to the world title picture where he belongs. Tony Khan's tweet along with the Observer reports suggests that the mystery man is indeed the Limitless One, although at this point, only time will tell. And before you go, make sure you check out the truth behind the secret wrestling returns of CM Punk.